Guys, are you ready to shoot a messenger? If you are ready, don't watch my video. It's not good. It's not good. Sawasdee ka. It's me, Teya, Suchira. If you want to know more about Thailand, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you will not miss anything about my country. As I told you in my last video that Thailand is going to reopen the country in October, and also we opened the country for only one kind of visa, which is called STV or Special Tourist Visa. Today I'm going to tell you how to get here with all the guidelines. So as you know that this kind of visa is like a premium long stay visa, which it means that you can stay in Thailand for at least 90 days and then you can extend twice. The longest time that you stay here is 270 days. Special tourist visa is provided by a tourism authority of Thailand, which they work for a ministry of tourism and sport. So I have a guideline for you if you're interested to come here by STV. First one, you have to contact TAT in your town. For example, like if you live in China, you just contact Tourism Authority of Thailand in China. But if your country location, you don't find TAT in your country, I recommend you to contact Tourism Authority of Thailand by website. Otherwise, another one, you can contact the representative company which is run for the Tourism Authority of Thailand. So this one is just like a Thailand long stay company, the one which I talk about in a previous video. So you just write email to them that you are interested to come here by STV visa and just wait for them. And I believe that if you're not allowed to come, they will inform you. They will inform you, like for example, like you come from... Sorry. For example, like you come from Brazil, for example, they probably will tell you like, oh, I'm sorry that Brazil is still like very high risk. Can you please wait? We would consider and we will let you know later. This is what I expected to hear from them. And also some of you guys who follow my channel, they also forward an email that they got it from Thailand Long Stay. So they also inform him and her like that, just like, you know, this is like acknowledged and then we will just inform you later. So if I were you, I would contact them just to make sure first that if you would be allowed to go or not. If you hear back from them, I believe for in case that you will be the one who will be allowed to come into this country, then you can continue the next process. So after you get informed that you will be qualified to come to get application, you need to have a document to be complete. Like one, you need to do a booking of 14 days quarantined at the hotel, or it can be at the hospital, just in case you come here for a medication. So it depending on what you are coming here for. And after that, you also need to have accommodation like a pre-post after you stay for 15 days quarantine. For example, like after ASQ, you have to prove the accommodation that you already booked after you just go out of the hospital or the hotel after the quarantine. The third one, you need to have health insurance for just in case you have COVID-19 or you are sick here. At least you need to cover $100,000. And next one, you need to have a charter flight or a private jet booking. For this part, I have no idea how to book a charter flight. I mean, private jet, I know like you can arrange, but the charter flight, in my opinion, I think you will get more information by the Tourism Authority of Thailand. I think they will give you suggestions like, you know, when they're going to have a charter flight and then when you can fly and join with them. I think the Tourism Authority of Thailand is the best person who can tell you about the charter flight. And then after they inform you, you just make a booking with them and then That's it. And after you apply and send all these documents, Tourism Authority of Thailand is going to send your name to immigration to just have a look about your name. Are you okay? This person is okay to come to Thailand or not? Hopefully okay. And then you just wait. And after that, this document also will send it to the Ministry of the Foreign Affairs and also CCSA and also the Ministry of the Sport and Tourism. Three big organizations that they need to see your document. And everything is all proof. They are going to give you COE. COE is a certificate of eligibility. How to say eligible. Is that right? Eligible. Whatever. You know it. And also STV. COE and STV will be passed to Thai embassy in your country. So when you go to collect COE and also STV, they would need more document from you, which is like a copy and a reservation, a proof of payment. So I believe that when you first apply, firstly, you don't have to pay yet until you get COE and STV, and then you will pay. And then you just show the payment to collect COE and STV. Okay, very confusing. And also you need to have fit to fly certificate, which it means that you are healthy, and this certificate you need to have it like 72 hours before you fly, and then you start to fly to Thailand. Once when you arrive, you will be screened at on arrival. And just in case they found you have positive carrier, you will be brought to be in the hospital. For the person who arrived here and we found you negative, you will be directly started to have the undergo for 14 days at the hospital or at the hotel where you are already booked, alternative state quarantine hotel, or another choice, which is called alternative local quarantine. And after that, during you are staying in a hotel, you can shop online, so you can buy food or do anything online, and then they will deliver to your room. And also you need to have two times checking COVID-19, first when you arrive and the second time when you're done. And this one is already including to picking you up, you know, staying in a hotel, the test and a service that you have to do during the hospital, who come to take care of you, and also food, which is like a three meals food. This kind of detail price is also different, so you have to contact each hotel which you're interested to do a booking with them. And after 14 days quarantine, you can be out, you can be free. But one thing that you can't be free is you need to have the mobile phone application which they can find you where you are in this country. Just in case you are sick or you have COVID-19, they can find you, and also they can find people who surround you. But I hope it's not things that bad. I mean, after you stay for a quarantine for 14 days, I believe everybody will be safe traveling freely, but you need to have the mobile phone application for finding you. But more things which is like a little bit more complicated is I heard that the doctor, they would request you to do a quarantine, like a house isolated at home before you fly as well. So for this information, I have no information like how many days you need to have home isolated before you fly. So you may need to get this information from Thai embassy, but I feel like, wow, this is quite strict. They are very strict about being healthy when you fly to Thailand. But however, even though it's very, very strict, First month that they're going to do, they would provide it only like three flights in 1 week, and each flight they only need only 100 tourists to be on a flight. So they expected to have like 1,200 tourists per month. However, you know, even though it's very complicated and many of you are not happy about it, but do you believe me, it's more than 2,000 tourists who are already started to show up that they wanted to come and they're willing to do everything as Thai government requests them. So we also have now the tourists from Myanmar, the tourists from China, and the tourists from Kuwait, and also from Japan. They said that this amount of people would help to generate Thailand to have income for 115 million baht. So I hope that the economy in Thailand will be better. And the Minister of the Tourism and Sport also mentioned like it seems like within a month, on the first month, that they expected to have like only 1,200 tourists. It's probably like fully booking already. And if it's work and it's getting better, they said that they're going to increase more tourists to come to Thailand more in the second phase, phase two or phase three. And you know, probably in the future, after they just try slowly, step by step, I think in the future, I hope that you guys who are willing to do this and anywhere in the world, I hope you can come to Thailand as you wish as well. So today, this is all the things that I have for you. So I hope that you feel like you get more information and a better picture about what is going on. So again, as I mentioned to you before, that the government do not announce to us that which country will be allowed. So I believe that if you're willing to come, better contact to Thailand Long Stay or TAT, and I will send you the link under my description so you can contact them directly. And you are willing to just write email to me or forward an email to me, and I can't do anything because I don't know anyone. I only look for the information and the news for you, and this is all I have and I know, and then I give it to you. So any further questions, probably the Tourism Authority of Thailand or Thailand Long Stay can tell you better than me. But if you have any more information, please share with me as well, because I don't know everything. I just look for the news for you from all the media that I could read. So I hope that today you get more information from me. And if you like it, please give me a thumb up, so I know that what I'm doing is good things for you. And if you appreciate it with information that you have, you want to support my channel and you feel like you want to buy me a coffee, you can read down here how to buy me a coffee, and thank you so much in advance. And also if you have any questions, you need some suggestions, and also you haven't subscribed me yet, please subscribe, because I don't have only Thailand news for you. I still have many things interesting, and then you can learn Thailand with me. Thank you so much for watching until the end. I'll see you next time. สวัสดีค่ะ